And now we're back here at the beautiful Capitol Center in Landover, Maryland. And let's go up to our ring announcer, Marv Brooks.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout, one fall with a 20-minute time limit. The participants from Stamford, Connecticut, weighing 255 pounds, Garea Altimore. His opponent from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 242 pounds, Tony Garea.
Here we go, slated one fall, 20 minutes. The Stamford Stomper, Tony Altimore, takes on the very impressive Tony Garea. Two Tonys in the ring, but one's ability far exceeds the other, in my opinion. Tony Garea, five-time co-holder of the World Tag Team Championship. That doesn't happen by accident, ladies and gentlemen. You've got to have a lot on the ball. Tony Altimore, been around pro wrestling circuits for many, many a year and knows it all, knows how to do it. He'll give Tony Garea a run for the money. You can guarantee that. Boy, we've had some super action here tonight at the Capitol Center. Magnificent Morocco holding on to that championship belt against the onslaught of sensational Rocky Johnson. Match ending in a count out as Morocco hung up, literally hung up between the top and second ropes with no way to escape. Referee had no choice but to count him out. I'm positive that Johnson did not want to win that way. Johnson wanted that 1-2-3 counter, that I give up, I submit, shouted from the Magnificent One, so that Rocky Johnson could strut out of here victorious with the championship belt. Unfortunately, that did not happen. I'm sure that there'll be a return match between these two superstars of pro wrestling in the very near future. Oh! Altimore dropped straight on his back, claiming Tony Garea had pulled his hair. Tony Garea wasn't anywhere near the hair of Tony Altimore. Referee just might have caught that move. Young referee Joe Morello just making his way into the World Wrestling Federation. Extremely agile, extremely quick. And the ladies tell me extremely good looking. I don't know, I'll let you folks be the judge of that. Tony Altimore motioning to our table, looking for some some sort of advice from us. He's saying, go ahead, give me your best shot. Down on his knees, telling Tony Garea, go ahead, give me your best shot right here. I'm sure he's just being facetious. Tony should let him have one. That would be the end of that. Still to come, former world's champion, superstar Billy Graham, putting on the tights tonight against Salvatore Bellomo. Outstanding match. Salvatore Bellomo, since entering the World Wrestling Federation, has an unblemished, undefeated record. Great night of wrestling, great matches, card of great magnitude being brought to you on USA Cable. Altimore having a running conversation here with a fan at ringside. Probably someone he brought himself, because I don't think there's one Tony Altimore fan in the entire Capitol Center tonight. Right hand blocked nicely by Garea and dropped Altimore like a sack of potatoes with a huge right. Complaining to the referee now. After all the things he's done here tonight, certainly doesn't have any point to complain to the referee about. Nice arm drag by Garea. And another. Arm bar now applied by Tony Garea. Altimore asking the referee if this is a legal hold or not. Altimore spinning around now. Knows he must come to his feet to get out of this particular hold. Oh, look at, he's trying to hair, he's trying to reach the eyes, the mouth, the lips, anything. Raleigh backed him into the ropes. That'll constitute a break. Guaranteed you won't see a clean break from Tony Altimore. Oh, he didn't have any choice there. Tony Garea loaded up on him. One false move and he'd have got it. Altimore at one time won half of the tag team championship as he and the unbelievable Captain Lou Albano held the title. It's been many a year, but it's in the record books. Tony Garea, on the other hand, numerous times as the World Wrestling Federation tag team champion. Well, Altimore's got the upper hand here. Pushing Garea down to the mat. He doesn't like it. It's amazing how much advantage you can get by using the hair. Garea going for the ride. Went for a backdrop. Nobody there. No one home. Tony Garea just hung onto the ring ropes. Altimore upset. He was perched there like a camel waiting for Garea to come off those ropes to initiate that backdrop, but Tony's just too smart for that. He's warning him verbally now. Garea off the ropes. Wild right hand, completely missed, sends Altimore to the canvas. Garea over for the cover. He won't get it. He slipped out the back door rather quickly. Altimore did more damage to himself with that one move than Garea did to him in the last 5 minutes. Oh, Garea went for the backdrop, and Altimore wisely planted the size 12 and a half right under the chin. Nice defensive move by Tony Altimore, the Stanford Stomper. There goes Garea. Goes for the backdrop. Sunset flip coming up. One, two. Oh, he caught him with a boot in the forehead. Made him break the hold. Looked like curtains there. Altimore now in the corner, lefts and rights. Throws Garea into the turnbuckle. Nice leapfrog. Oh, and a high crossbody. He's got the leg hook. He got a three count. Tony Garea, big high cross body off the second turnbuckle. Stunning the Stanford Stomper. Let's take a look at what we saw just a moment ago. All right, here's Altimore giving Garea a turnbuckle. Tony hits a hard corner, but comes off with a beautiful leapfrog. Goes up to the second turnbuckle, turns. There's Altimore in the center of the ring. Down on top, hooks the back leg. Joe Morella right down there for the three count. And a victory, and let's go to our ring announcer.
The time, 13 minutes and 8 seconds. The winner, Tony Garea.
We'll be right back with more from the Capitol Center in just a moment. You're watching the World Wrestling Federation Championship Wrestling on the USA Cable Network.